But now we're going to move on to what I think is the most crucial part of this entire journey is our story. It's storytelling. Part of my identity that I took on that really saw a change in my posture, my mindset, how I went about the business is that I'm a well-paid storyteller. I'm a professional storyteller. I gather stories, I hear them, I remember them, I collect them, and I retell them. And remember back to start with why. People buy why we do, not what we do. It's through our story that we get to bring that to life. So when you think about the stories that you remember the most, when you think about when you think about last year's game plan, what was the moment? I bet you it was a story. From conference, who heard an NMD speech that just helped them believe that this is possible for you too? Five of you? Come on. It's all about the stories, isn't it? The how-to's great, and we always are so tempted to keep lost on the how-to. I want the magic secret. I want the blueprint. I want the next step. And it's the how. And really, it's the why, and the why comes to life through our story. So when you know your real story, the part where you get to connect with your limbic system, where you drop out of the mind and you start being in your heart and feeling, this is one of the most powerful tools that we can give you. So to me, storytelling, I just found a collection of some of my favorite quotes. But think about it, we've been telling stories for centuries. It's how we've always learned. So back to when we were cavemen and women, we had to be able to explain. I've just been on a 3-day journey and I went over the mountains and through the forest and then I turned left at the big rock and don't eat those berries there, they're going to kill you. My friend died. Don't eat the blue ones, but the pink ones are amazing. And this part of our brain activates and we go into a trance, the best kind of trance, because we're in this learning, feeling state. So the best speakers take us on those little journeys. The best tool that we can empower you with is this incredible tool that will help you connect with people at the speed of light, just like that. So for me, stories are the best way to communicate, persuade, coach, inspire, and get your outcome. So I'm never telling people that they need Juice Plus. I'm asking questions. I'm getting curious. I'm investigating some of the things that they're loving in their life, maybe some of the things that aren't working yet, some things that aren't yet how they want it to be. And then I'm collecting all of that part of their story. And then I can ask just one question. And then I can use this beautiful bridging statement of, well, first of all, let me share a little bit about my story. Here's why I said yes to starting these products. And this is what it's done for me. And that is going to entice someone into your world and put them in a bit of a trance. So all the filters of no and why not begin to collapse, and we now get to be in a conversation. So we're going to have some fun with this at the moment. I'm going to start in your workbook there. We're up to page 6. I love acronyms. So does Fraser. I think he's even got an acronym for how much he loves acronyms. I came up with this in the shower where I do all my best thinking. I think it's the shower cap is like my thinking cap. But if you think about, I really love movies. I love looking at how they're put together. I love the hero's journey. Can't we always see the hero's lesson that they need to learn? That they just resist. And it's when they finally grow that they set themselves free. So we are so geared, wired like cave people to listen to people's stories. So if you look at PLOT, is the acronym, because every great movie, every great hero, every great story has the plot. Sometimes we lose the plot, right? That's when we're in a spin in confusion. The plot will bring you back. So this is simple, and it's a simple reminder, and I do this with everyone when they're brand new, because I feel if I didn't teach them another thing for the first few weeks, this is all they need, is to remember their own story. And I remember one of my beautiful mentors, Cheryl Cortese, saying, Linda, your story is everything. No one can take argument with your story. They're not going to say that's BS. They might with product and research and Google and this profession, all of those things, but not your story. So that made so much sense to me that I could carry that with me. This comes in my posture. This is mine and it's real. And I'll never forget it because it's my story. So let's look at your plot. Let's just have fun with this for a few minutes. So what in your life, let's start with pain. P starts with pain. It was the thing that wasn't working. What was preventing you? What was the thing that was not comfortable? Because let's face it, we say yes to a business like this when we are not satiated. Have a think about it. You said yes to this because there was a gap. You wanted more. You wanted something to be different and something to change. So just for a quick 30 seconds there, think about just when you said yes, look how far you've come already. But I want you to take a 30-second journey back to when you said yes. And start to dig out some of the things that weren't working back then. And while you're in that mode, L, let's move on to L. What was the lesson? What was the moment? What was the threshold? Enough is enough. Fraser has a picture to capture his, where he had half an eye open in the foam, and he even had the time and date captured. Threshold is a beautiful thing. And then while you're at it, what was the opportunity that you saw? What was the solution? What did you see with this? What got you? What was that hope or dream? What did you see in your friend or what they were sharing with you? What was it about their story, their journey? What got you? And then T. T stands for triumph. Even if you don't feel like you're at the top of the mountain in full triumph, what could you already notice about your progress, what you're proud of, what you're excited about, what you're continuing to grow and step into? What's your T? What has you excited to jump out of bed? Know that there's more for you. And that, my friends, is your plot. How simple and easy is that? And I can see most of you are actually really connected to that right now. So now I'm going to invite one of my beautiful friends, first and foremost. Kate Gourlay is a 100 Club NND. She is an author. She is a producer. She stars in her own documentary. She is a mama of three. She's a coach. And she's just one of the best humans on the planet. And the thing I love about Kate, come on up, Katie. The thing I love about Katie is when I see her connect with people, she does it really quietly, really elegantly, incredibly powerfully, and she interviews them. She's an absolute master asker. And so for those of you who are kind of like, I don't have a good sob story. I think we had that question yesterday. I don't have a sob story. I wish I had an autoimmune. I wish I was a celiac. I wish my kid had rashes and needed a bleach bath. That'd be amazing if I had that story. My story's shit. Who's feeling like that? You're coming up. Yeah. Oh, surprise. She didn't know, Anne. Come on up. One more.
Let's give them a round of applause.
Thanks, buddy. Oh, Katie, you're going to work your magic. No. Let's give them a round of applause because this is big. They've got, this is not scripted. This is live TV.
Hi. So let's start with you. I'm just going to give you the mic. Can you tell everyone your name and where you're from?
Hey, I'm Elizabeth Walker and I'm from Sydney.
Awesome. So I would love to ask you a few questions and just try and help you develop your story a little more powerfully. Is that okay?
Perfect.
Excellent. So what would you say in your life right now isn't working so well for you?
I didn't want to cry.
I have that effect on people, I'm sorry.
Normally it's me sitting in that chair. And a lot of you know that, like there's people here who know me. I had a really challenging month and I've just lost a little bit of self-belief.
Okay. And so when you're sharing your story at the moment,
Yep. Are
you sharing that little tough bit?
No.
Okay. So share your background with me first. What does life look like for you at the moment?
Oh, God. I run a really big business that exploded in the last 6 months, separate to this.
Yeah.
I joined this 2 months ago and just missed out on Super Builder.
Amazing. What have you been saying no to in the last few years that is no longer okay with you?
My health.
Your health.
Yeah.
So you've built this amazing business
prior
to Juice Plus, but your health has come at a cost.
Well, my health was bad before the business and the business kind of compensated for having bad health.
Yep.
And I guess I've just keep saying that my body can't do that. So I used to be a flying trapeze artist.
How?
This is not the body of a flying trapeze artist.
And what would you love life to look like in the future?
I'd like to be able to wear that dress.
Awesome, okay.
Or the one who the other person's wearing, but I don't know her name, but she's the blonde girl that, Vicky, you know her name, the girl you said you'd followed for ages. I think she's a famous person here. I don't know her. I haven't been around long enough. She wore black yesterday, black pants. That's her, that one. She's got a really pretty dress on.
Awesome. So what if you were able to share? You know what, I used to have a really successful business and prior to that I was actually a trapeze artist. I took such pride in my body and my health. But then things got a little out of control. And although I had success in my business, I found that I wasn't actually making myself a priority. And then I came across an amazing opportunity, and it has completely changed my life and perspective on how I take care of me and how I help other families do the same. And so my vision for my future is that I get back to that old me, that I'm nourishing my body every day, and that I'm actually putting myself first, and then everything else comes after that.
That would be awesome. And I love that, because there's no horrible bits in that.
No.
And that's been my struggle. I said yesterday that I didn't have a sob story. Well, I've got a big, big sob story. I just don't like using it. And that's a much better way to do it. Thank you.
Cool. You're
Thank
welcome.
Thank you so much.
Good job. Okay.
Hi.
Hello, what's your name and where are you from?
I'm Chloe and I'm from Melbourne.
Chloe, okay. Awesome. And Chloe, tell us what does life look like for you at the moment?
At the moment, I'm working 9 to 5 in customer service. When I first said yes to the business, I was actually in traditional business, in events and weddings, and it was a lot of fun, but I wasn't enjoying the long hours and the lack of flexibility and the working on the weekends. So I decided to join the business when we decided to sell the other business.
And what have you been saying no to for too long?
Traveling, and I also really love the country, and I would love to move to the country. But my parents moved to Melbourne for more opportunity, so I always thought I was stuck there if I wanted to make something of myself.
And who would you love to travel with, or who would you love to give back to?
My partner, Alex. And I've always really just wanted to make a positive impact on the world as well.
Awesome. And you haven't felt that your story's been worthy of sharing?
I think I've had a belief that because I'm not a mum, I can't do this business or I can't connect with people enough for them to connect with it. Yeah.
Where's all of our people in the room that aren't parents? There we go. Look at them all. Amazing. So, can I give an interpretation of how I might share that? And I want you guys to think whether it's your story or your coaching, your team, to be able to pull their story out of them and make them realize that they matter is so important. So, my name's Chloe and I've been working a 9 to 5 for a while. It's not my dream job, but my real passion, I've never been afraid of hard work. But I've always wanted to find something that I can make an impact on and helping women and families live their best life. And I don't have children yet, but I know how I want to show up as a mama, and that's being there for my family when I have them. Being able to travel with those that I love, and I'm so excited because I've said yes to an opportunity that's allowing me to say yes to more and build my dreams for the future and help many others along the journey with me. Cool. Thank you. Let's give these ladies a round of applause. Thank you so much. You're amazing. Keep jumping. Awesome. Thank you. Did you want to? Wow. Yes. That's awesome. So I guess with what I just did there, guys, just being able to ask a few questions. One of my favorite questions that I ask is, what are you saying no to now that isn't okay anymore? Or who's someone that you'd love to help that you can't right now? Because that starts to dig a little bit deeper into, you know, the dreams and desires of yourself and your team to be able to then think about, because we shut it down. We shove those things down. Because we just are in that survival mode week in, week out. And there's someone that you can't help. There's someone that you aren't able to spend time with right now that you'd love to.
And so let's look in the book and begin to craft more. Take a seat. It's like on the seat with us. Now we want you to delve into this a bit more with a bit more heart, a bit more limbic system. See how easy it is for others. Someone kindly called out BS. Isn't it easy to see other people's story that's blocking them, but it's kind of like a cruel joke that we have our blinders on. It's just our own blind spot. But someone else can really elegantly and easily, with the right question, help someone just reveal. It's like just handing them a gentle little mirror and going, oh, look, maybe what about this? What about this? Maybe this would work. And this process is going to allow you to do that. So you don't have to be a master coach. You don't have to be super experienced. You can literally sit down with your new team and say, let's really capture what this could really be for you. We have this cool, quick little acronym that's going to help us get there. And let's start with this. So just like we guided you through that, this is what I honestly believe. When I don't do this at the start with someone new, they're kind of flying blind and they feel like they don't have the skills and the tools yet, and that they get obsessed about the how-to and a blueprint. Whereas I believe it's my first and most important job is to let them know that they're already enough and that the story is everything. And that we're going to show you and teach you everything else that you need to know as you need to know it. But nothing's more important than your story. You can always be confident in it. You're bulletproof in your own story. It's going to evolve. And I want them to know that all-important statement. Well, first of all, let me share a little bit about my story. Then, of course, you get out of telling people why they should take Juice Plus. Take Juice Plus or die is what I used to... That used to be my story. And I used to take an hour to tell people why they should take Juice Plus or die, didn't I? Yes. Kate, bless her soul, was at my first event, which was a flip chart for 1 hour of take Juice Plus or die. Look, the doctors say it. The research says it. You get 4 times more antioxidants. You're full of free radicals, and my blood's so much better than yours. And if you don't do what I do, you're going to die. My sheer passion was enough that people forgave me. They could see past it. But when I became more elegant and more succinct, now I have this internal confidence that if I listen really connected to who is this person, you saw Katie in action. She just sat with these two women and hopefully forgot that there's over 1,000 watching, and you just had a conversation. Hey, what are you saying no to? What's not been working? What would you love to change? How would that feel? What if we can show you a way that you can create more of this and this, even though this is going on? Yeah, and it's a conversation. So take a look in your book, and let's just take 1 minute for you to just really write through some of your favorite words that you got from there. And we've given a bunch of examples because remember, we're all storytellers and you collect stories. You just heard 2 more stories to add to your collection. And it's like a shopping trolley for the day. You get to borrow, oh, I like that word, mum care instead of daycare. I craved impact while I was making income. I wanted more purpose. So you're collecting all the different ideas that are shaping and evolving your story. So let's just take 1 minute as we finish up this section of what you like best.
All right, guys, if you can finish what you're writing, that would be amazing. So I'm going to switch gears a little bit and more stories, which I love, and going to be sharing with you around our amazing products, because let's be real, we all would not be here if it wasn't for our incredible Juice Plus products. Linda had you rate your belief in the level of our products. Who here would love to increase that today? Awesome. You're definitely going to do that. So funny that Linda mentioned I don't have a clicker. Yay. Funny that Linda mentioned her event that she did. That was about 9 years ago. I know Rach is somewhere in the audience. She was there with me and she absolutely flip charted us. And at that time, I felt sorry for my friend. I bought the products. I put them in the back of the cupboard. They kept on getting delivered. And my lovely husband said to me, if those things come anymore, like, what are you doing? And I didn't take them. And it's kind of ironic that I'm up here teaching around our amazing products now, because they are absolutely incredible. And if one of the things that I like to say is, you know, that we're really building a nutritional foundation for thousands of families every single day. People can go do yoga, they can exercise, they can drink more water. All of those things are amazing, but when we're getting that nutritional baseline every day, lives are impacted, as you're going to hear in just a second. So our products are so amazing. And I know there's some of you that you're literally so new to the team, you don't even have your products yet sitting in this room, which is pretty amazing. It is just about plants. It's just about getting more plants in. The more whole food that we can get into our body every single day, the more our body can heal and function and do our best. And so one of the things that I wanted just to touch on first, Peter and Louise shared this with me earlier, is I know we've had questions around when are the changes happening to our products. Take a photo of this. I know this is going to be posted in the New Zealand and Australian franchisee page, but these are all the latest changes, upgrades to our products, where the lemon peel is being now used instead of folic acid. And my understanding is, and I know they're up here on stage a little bit later, but what we've got is products that are already starting to roll out in Australia. It hasn't completely happened, but as stocks are already being used, the new ones are coming out at the moment. So pawpaw has been changed to mango, so we can get better sources of that. And we're also taking out the oats and putting in more rice bran so we can be gluten-free as well. So it's really exciting. And I have the MTFHR gene and all that stuff. All those things, all those people that you've been speaking to before, you'll be able to help them really, really soon. So in the coming weeks and months, that complete rollout is going to be in Australia and New Zealand, which is pretty cool. So I really see our products as a one-stop shop. There is literally nothing on the planet like our Juice Plus products. There's no product that comes close. You've got all of your brands out there with their brilliant marketing campaigns. But when you think about that, our whole food capsules are addressing our immune system, boosting our immune system every single day. That our nervous system health, and whatever Fraser was talking about before, is really helped with our omegas. And then our gut health is being nourished from our incredible complete smoothie. So we really are a one-stop shop when it comes to really helping families make those upgrades in their lifestyle, that consistent and healthy nutrition to the body. But I wanted to share a couple of cool numbers with you guys. So some of you may have heard this first one, but there's a couple of things that I feel. I spoke to several leaders. What did they feel that they wanted to know that more franchisees knew about our incredible products? And one of the things that I love about our company is the quality of what they do is paramount. A few years into the business, Anthony and I we were in San Diego and we actually did a walk of the encapsulation plant. So we put our little hairnets on and actually walked through that. And just seeing the quality of what this company does to be able to provide our products the way that they are is amazing. 1 million is the amount of dollars, Australian dollars worth of product that was rejected last year by the Juice Plus company. So I just think that's incredible, because our products are tested for 300 contaminants 4 different times, through when the product's picked, to when it's turned up into a slushy, to when the moisture's taken out, to then when the powders are blended together into the whole food capsule. four separate times for 300 different contaminants. And so in the last year, they rejected over $1 million. I just think that is incredible, that this company is so particular about what they're delivering every single time. Pretty cool, huh? The other thing that I think you guys want to know about is that we have 35 peer-reviewed medical journal studies done on our products, and there is many more to come. And people will say, yeah, but the products, your company's paying for the research. I just want to explain something to you guys. Every single university or facility out there that is studying our products, yes, the Juice Plus company has to give the products to them. That's a given. But what comes from there, the results, the research, the time, everything, that is something that the Juice Plus company has zero control over. So the results speak for themselves. The numbers, the research, it is absolutely phenomenal. And there's some really great short videos actually breaking down the results from the research that's there. You can go to the Juice Plus YouTube channel and see those. And it just gives you so much more confidence in the company that we have. So there's many more studies to come, but just know when someone says, oh yeah, but you know, they paid for the research. We can't pay for the research. It's just not possible. Yes, we give the products to the university and then they do the rest. So I think that's pretty cool. 25, that's the number of years that the Juice Plus products have been around. And zero is the number of batches that have been recalled by our Juice Plus company in the last 25 years. I think that's pretty incredible. I think that deserves a round of applause. Five is the number the average Australian and New Zealand franchisee, five customers is the average. Who would like to increase that average today? Yeah, I want to definitely increase that average. Well, I'm going to blow your mind and bring out three incredible women. They each have over 50 plus personal customers. They aren't some social media guru with a million followers. They didn't have a health background, like none of that. They are just pure heart-driven women on a mission to make a huge impact. And I know we are going to learn so much for them. So can we please welcome the lovely Janae Giddy, the lovely Natasha Gallier, and Sandra Cooper. Come on up. Take a seat. You can sit. Just take a seat there. How amazing. So you ladies are definitely setting the standard for, you know, what we can look forward to create in our business. So I am just super excited to hear what you all have to share with us. The first thing, let's start with you, Janae. And one of the things that I love about each of the women that are up here is they aren't extroverts. They aren't these outgoing, like, in-your-face people. They are just beautiful, heart-centered people. And one of the things Janae won't tell you, I actually did a count on your customers yesterday. You have almost 80 personal customers. Like, fire. So I would love you to share with us, how have you even created that? I know it's not been from some magic Facebook post or anything like that. You shared a lot about building relationships and sharing your journey. So let's hear it.
Hi, everyone. Very nervous to start off with. First of all, when I started the business, I did not have the self-belief. I did not go out and speak to 1,000 people when I first started. It scared the crap out of me to talk to anyone about what I was doing. Like, what are you doing? Oh, I just work in local government. I don't do anything else. And that took a lot of, logging into training. That was a non-given. I had to do that every week and to build that self-belief. But when I started to talk to people, I just realized so many people out there are just wanting someone to listen to them. That's it.
Yeah.
And I don't talk to people thinking, oh, this is a sale. I'm talking to someone that this is just a person. So I just really am huge on just listening to their story, listening to what's not working in their life and what they're missing, and just caring about that person and just loving them where they're at, and huge on building relationships. And, you know, if later on down the track the conversation comes up about the products, then fantastic. But really, I'm just huge on just wanting to love that person and care about them and just listen to them, because so many people are missing that in their life.
And you've been on the team now for a couple of years.
2 years.
Yeah. And what would you say to everyone out there that has starting the conversations, but you know, we all want them to place the order now. You've obviously got a little bit of patience. How often do you follow up? How can you even attract 80 customers?
Just talking to people and listening to people. Like I can be sometimes just in a conversation, say at, you know, at dancing, and one of the mums might be talking about, Lily's really tired lately. And I say, look, I don't know if this can work for you. This is what's worked for me and my family and my kids. Can I share something with you? And it's as simple as that. And if it's like, yep, great. If it's no, then that's okay. But it's just listening to people and looking for those opportunities to really pay attention to what someone's saying and look a bit deeper to what they're saying, I guess, also. Those things that they might not share straight away and just, yeah, really just paying attention to what they're saying.
Awesome. Well, you shared an example of a post that you've done as well that has also created some really great interaction. Yes. So can we just bring that up if that's possible? Because I know you're not huge on social media, but when you do things, I know this post had a lot of interaction that you got. And this is just a great idea for you guys to look at modelling. I love modelling success, and you're going to hear a lot of great things that these women are doing that you can look to create something of your own. So can you share a little bit about this?
So I just wanted to be able to share something with someone without, you know, just as a giveaway, as a bit of fun, as a bit of just creating some conversations online. Like I said, I didn't have a huge amount of friends when I first started the business. I had, like, I think maybe 500, if that. And so I just wanted to be able to, yeah, create some conversations and just give something back to people, you know, without them having to buy anything off me. So I did. I just put it out there and got heaps of conversations. And then I did a live with my daughter because she wanted to be involved. I'm pretty sure she could do the business on her own now. She's 10. I did a live with her, and we did the draw, you know, drew the names out of the hat and announced it live then who were our winners of the and it was great. I got a couple of customers out of it, but I was able to share our products and just get curiosity around, you know, what we're doing.
Yeah, awesome. The other thing that I love about what you had shared when we were speaking earlier is when you start a customer, you're very deliberate in them understanding what their commitment is, and that there's no, oh, I didn't know there was a recommitment, and I didn't know there was, you know, monthly payments or anything like that. I'm just going to bring up an example that you shared with us of a message that you send out to your customers. Can you share a little bit more?
I think because this was one of my things when I first joined the business was like, oh my God, it's going to be reshipped. What are people going to, you know, they're not going to like that. So I just created a message where I made it really clear that yes, it gets reshipped, but I make sure I touch base with every single one of my customers before that date. And I let them know that, you know, if it's not working for them for whatever reason, I just let them know that there is a way that they can say, hey, Janae, is it okay if I stop or delay this? And I make that clear. And I send this out before, so they may have already given me their credit card details, but I still send this out first. This is an absolute given every time I do an order for that reason. It just makes it clear it's going to be in 4 months, but I'm going to let you know when that's due to be shipped. And if you need to delay it because you haven't been taking every day, not a problem. Easily done. And I think everyone just goes, oh, yeah, okay, cool. Yep. Yeah.
And that's made a big difference in your retention as well, hasn't it?
Yes, absolutely. So I think because they know, it just takes that little bit of self-doubt off the people of, you know, around what we're doing. And it does. And then I have a lot of customers who don't take it every day. And I just say, that's okay. We can just delay it for a month. And they go, okay, I'm comfortable with that. And so they stick around, which is really great. And then I say, now take it every day.
Amazing. So putting their needs first and really hearing what they're looking for. Amazing. Awesome. Thank you. Now we're going to hear from Natasha. Yay.
Hi, everyone. You're amazing. I'm super nervous, but I'm actually quite calm also. It's a bit weird.
Good.
Yeah. I just wanted to share a few stories. Probably when I first became involved in this business, I was in a lot of financial pain. Something that I couldn't share when I first started. My whole family, we lost everything and we had to move in with my parents. And that was a long, very long 12 months, and five of us moved in with my mum and dad. And thanks mum and dad for doing that. They're not here, but amazing. 4 months later, I started my business when I moved into my parents' house, and I worked out of their office, and I was surrounded by their beautiful antiques, but it just wasn't me. And I used to be on my Zoom calls and sit there wondering whether people were thinking, why is she in this really old-fashioned house? And sure enough, people would say, I would say, I'm at my parents' house. And many times they would say, oh, you're always at your parents' house. And I just wasn't comfortable to say, I'm at my parents' house because we lost everything and we have no money. So that's my little story there. But I'm not sure if you've ever had a nice lifestyle and you've lost it, but there's a lot of pain around that and a lot of feeling lost, failure, all those different emotions. And I know for myself, I would put on a happy face, go to school, act out everything was all right, but behind the scene, I was a mess, and this business just came in the right time for myself. Now, the reason why I'm telling you this is that this pain really, really drove me, clearly, when I started my business. I could see that, quite factual, I suppose, that getting 10 customers would make me $610. That's pretty much what it came down to. I needed the money. So I just got on and I started having conversations with people. I also made my goal, like I knew how much money I needed each month, and that became my goal for customers. What I've also learned along the way is that you need to have a lot of fun with this, and this took me, I did have fun, but I was very obviously very focused, and my beautiful husband reminds me that you need to have fun and build relationships, and I think you'll probably hear from today, it's really about building those relationships and just letting people know that you generally do care about them. You're not there for the sale, you just care about them. And a simple way to share with people is having conversations. And I know we always hear about it, but it's really looking for those opportunities to actually have conversations. So for example, just last week I went into the service station, 7-Eleven service station I go into all the time, and I make sure I chat to the owners and the staff that work there. And I could hear, they're always tired and someone's always sick, and I could hear her saying she was feeling really tired and had no energy. So obviously my ears pricked up. I was making myself a coffee, ironically. And I said to her, oh, hey, you know, I can make you a coffee if you like. And she said, oh, I've actually already had two coffees and I have a V drink behind the counter. And this was all before 9 a.m. And I was like, oh man, you know, she's really suffering. So I wanted to literally pounce right there and then and just say, I've got something for you. But no, I played it cool. The timing wasn't quite right, and when I went to go and pay, nobody was around. So I just said to her, look, you mentioned before you've been feeling tired. I have something that's really helped me. I'm not quite sure if it will help you, but if you're open, I can give you some info. And she said, yeah, absolutely. So, you know, I exchanged on Facebook, etc., and now we're in conversations with that. And as soon as I finished that conversation, five or so people came in and started to pay for the petrol. So the timing was perfect. But what was even more perfect than that was that because I had made that relationship with her, we're not best friends or anything like that, but a form of relationship with her, she was open to actually listen and to receive some information from me.
Amazing. And I love, I'm just going to bring a couple of pictures up, you sharing your own family's journey and the results that they've had. Obviously, you know, when you have an impact happen in your own family, you want to share it. And you've done such a beautiful job where that's drawn people. You sharing your pain that you've gone through and how that's had been able to help other people as well.
Yeah, this was a great post. My poor girl has eczema. It's way, way better than it's ever been before. But just to be able to share whatever you're experiencing from the product, and before and after photos are great. And this next one here also is, she suffered from constipation too. So I just shared that. And from both those posts, I had people approach me about it, because you'll find out suddenly all these kids are constipated and on Osmolax and everyone has eczema. So it's just a really good way to reach out to people and to help people. And I even had a friend like my post that her cousin saw, who then contacted me directly and wanted to know more information. And she became one of my top first customers.
Amazing. Awesome. Thank you so much, Anne. Sandra. Ready? Now, what I love about your story, Sandra, is you really see you taking care of your clients as you just give the most incredible customer care. So share with us a little bit about what, you know, how you've been able to help and attract so many clients and take care of them.
Thank you, Kate. The first thing is I really was sick in my life, and I understand the pain that people go through when they're not well. So for me to be able to help somebody is really what I feel is why I'm here on earth. I really just love to be able to make a difference, even if it's a small difference in somebody's life. And this product completely changed my life a lot of people know my story, so I had a lot of autoimmune issues and as well eczema and really bad allergies. So, and very quickly it healed my life. So I go out with complete 100% conviction that I know that I can change somebody's life. I think that's the first thing. In the beginning, like Janae, I was terrible at sharing this. I was in my head, not coming from my heart. It was all about me and not other people. And I always had Linda's voice saying, it's not about you, it's not about you, it's not about you. It's my mantra, it's not about you. And I get up every morning and to this day, it's not about you, Sandra. So when I do share with people, I'm really curious about them and I want to find out deeply what's going on for them. And I don't know about you, but not many people out in conversation will come and ask me, how are you? What's going on in your life? Like, I'm very observant and I notice that that very rarely happens, unless I'm here, of course, in this environment where people do genuinely care. So I make a real commitment to really delving deep and giving people the time to listen. And I never talk about myself, except if I'm sharing my story. So the first thing I do is ask 5 really good quality questions. Tell me about you, what's going on for you, how's your health? And within a minute, people are sharing. And I think if you genuinely care, they will feel that as well. So so when I'm out and about, I always have it in the back of my mind.
Always.
Who can I start a conversation with today? I love training. I love going to the gym. I've got 3 children. So I'm always meeting new people at the school. And I make a point of starting a new conversation with somebody that I have not met nearly every single day. Even if it's just to say hello in the school line waiting for the kids. I get there 10 minutes earlier. Try to. And I'll think, okay, who haven't I had a conversation with today? And it's really about building relationships. So I have been doing this now close to 4 years, and most of my customers have been with me this entire time, and the people that I do get onto our products, they stay with me because I feel that I have a really good relationship with them, I know them, and I really do genuinely care. So maybe we'll cover a bit more of the...
And one of the things just on that, so you have a questionnaire that you have your clients mm-hmm. fill out when they first get started. We might just bring up the slide if that's okay. And so you guys might want to take a photo of that. And this is just about modelling, you know. Some of you will do this, some of you won't, that's okay. But you have every single client fill this out.
I didn't at the beginning mm-hmm. and I just found that... by doing this, I remember Shani mentioned it quite a few years ago and I thought, that's a great thing. And it's totally turned my whole business around because, again, people feel that you care. You're not just trying to sell them a product. I love the fact that I can turn around, I say 4 months, but it happens a lot quicker, sometimes within weeks. It brings their pain to the surface. They've written it down, so they're conscious. Okay, yeah, I'm not sleeping that well. Yeah, I'm not pooping that well. My skin's not that great. I've had this, my energy's not that great. So within weeks, I get people going, oh my goodness, like, guess what? That's, you know, it's always the toilet thing first. and the skin starts to clear up. And I get so excited for them when they come and tell me and share their results. So after 4 months, I pull out this form, we go back to it, and it's really wonderful because a lot of people forget how crappy, am I allowed to say that? How bad they felt when they first started. And then 4 months on, they feel so fantastic. And I guess this is the thing too, moving forward as far as customers feeling good and then deciding that because they're having a marriage or there's some financial thing that comes up and they go off Juice Plus and then realise that it was actually really a lot better than what they thought, and then their health starts to decline and they always come back.
They always come back. Amazing. Just holding that space for them and knowing that that's going to eventually come about. Mm-hmm. Awesome. Well, one of the things that I love about all of these ladies that... I've just got another slide, sorry. Is that what they're great at is they're sharing stories. They're always thinking of what story can I share with this person, what's going to resonate with them. And what I really see is that our stories are the bridge from bringing the customers to our products or the products to our customers. I really see that. So I see stories as I have a tool belt of me where I've got stories about business, stories about products, and I'm constantly adding to them. A lot of you probably have a preview group that you would use, but just knowing these stories and learning them from events is so, so powerful. So we're going to have two lovely ladies come on up now, and so you can all add some more stories to your tool belt. We've got the beautiful Lauren and Melinda. Come on up, ladies. So thank you so much. I would love you to share your story, please.
Thank you.
Wow. Oh, there's a lot of people here.
There is.
So Juice Plus has helped me to save my own life. I've got a really ugly health story. I have two autoimmune conditions. I have bowel disease, which no one really likes to talk about. And I have arthritis as a result of that. About 5 years ago, I was so unwell and I really didn't honestly care about my health. I was on so much medication, I was in and out of hospital. I was basically at the point where I couldn't even care for myself anymore. There was a time where my mum was basically my main carer. She was, honestly, she was showering me and taking care of me. After lots of medication, I kind of thought I was better and I thought I was healthy, but I actually wasn't at all. I was just masking what was underneath a very, very awful health. So I fell pregnant and had my little girl, and then all of a sudden something changed. I was really run down and tired, you know, that story that everyone tells, you know, I'm a brand new mum, I'm exhausted, I'm this, I'm that. But I knew that something had to give, because if something didn't, then I wasn't going to be able to be a mum to my little girl, who was my absolute miracle. So I reached out to my friend and I said, I don't care what it is, just tell me it's safe for pregnancy and breastfeeding, and send it to me. Here's my credit card. Pretty quickly, I noticed some, you know, I guess, exciting results. So I was able to get out of bed to my daughter in the night. I was healing a lot quicker from my cesarean and I was just feeling a lot better in myself. But it was what has happened over the last nearly 3 years now that has absolutely transformed my life. I've lost nearly over 25 kilos on my journey. I've gotten myself down to one medication. Woo! I'm not. So I don't have to take steroids or anything to mask my health, because for the first time in, I think, about 20 years, I am actually a healthy person. I am healthy. And if it wasn't for these amazing products and the way that it makes me see health in my life now, I honestly do not know if I would be standing here right now. I actually don't even know if I would be here to be a mum to my little girl and a part of my family. So I am so grateful for these products in this company. So thank you.
Amazing. Hey, Lauren.
Hello. So a bit of backstory. My husband and I, we have a business within the mining industry. So he is away a lot. He's away more than he is home. And being self-employed, it means that he doesn't have a set roster. So he goes whenever, wherever, however long. So when it comes time for us to...
Can I have another mic?
Thank you. Sorry. When it comes time to deciding to have a family, I knew that it was going to be tough because I knew that I didn't have the support network, but boy, was I in for a rude awakening. In October 2014, I became a mum for the very first time to a beautiful, healthy little boy, Archie. And I remember one of my best friends, she used to say to me, the first 6 weeks are going to be the hardest. And I just remember counting down the days to the 6 weeks, because I knew that after 6 weeks, it was going to get easier. And I remember this day like it was yesterday. It was 6 weeks and one day after I gave birth, and I was standing in the shower, just the water was pouring over my head. I was hysterically crying, and I was like, what the F have I done? like, I decided to have a child and I can't go back, and this is the hardest thing I've ever done. And Archie got to about between 4 and 6 months old, and the postnatal depression started to kick in, and I was depleted on every single level, physically, mentally, emotionally. You know, I rocked the mum bun, and it was a greasy mum bun, but I rocked it. And the postnatal depression kicked my ass, you know, dare I say that. And I felt like I was a very organised person, and Archie got to 12 months of age, and my husband and I decided it was time to start trying for baby number two. But at this time, self-care was non-existent, and we were then starting one hell of a roller coaster. And the whole of 2016, I, on two separate occasions, got told that I was pregnant, and then at the 14-week mark, got told that I was no longer pregnant, and that still is, to this day, gut-wrenching. But I knew that I could fall pregnant. I did it twice, but my body was waving that white flag saying, I can't even look after you, let alone grow and develop a fetus. Got to the 12 months of trying, and my obstetrician said, you know, I think it's time I start to intervene. And I remember going home after that appointment to my husband and said, I don't need Western medicine help. I am by no means against it, but I can fall pregnant. I can do it. I just need to start looking after myself. And throughout the whole journey, I was watching an old school friend on Facebook, and she was always posting about these magic beans. And I was like, what the hell is a magic bean? Like, you know, she would say, like, you know, they give you energy and you get, you know, all these things and your sleep will improve. And I was just like, you know, whatever, I'm prepared to try it. So I messaged her and I said, I don't care what they are, as long as they're legal, I'll buy them. And within 2 weeks of I ordered the premium capsules, and within 2 weeks of them arriving, my sleep quality improved. I had more energy. I was actually able to wash my hair and straighten my hair, so the mum bun went. And within my first 4 month shipment, I conceived our little boy Xander. And my pregnancy was textbook perfect. And my body was actually in that good of a condition that Xander didn't even want to vacate, and I had to be induced. But recovery was amazing, and we've just celebrated his first birthday, and he's definitely the rainbow to my storm. He is beautiful. But self-care, like, if I have learnt one thing, self-care needs to be everyone's priority. Like, it has to be everyone's number one priority, because you can't fill other people's cups if your cup is empty. And I think the difference now is I choose to not let that define me. Like, you know, yes, I'm a mum and I'm kicking postnatal depression's butt back and taking my life over. And I now have this amazing story to share with so many people. And, you know, I feel that almost every single person in this room would have been in some way, shape or form affected by pregnancy loss. It's
amazing. Beautiful. Thank you so much. Our products are amazing, guys. They do change lives, and we all have that in our hands. So I hope, just a massive thank you to Melinda, to Lauren, to Janae, to Natasha, and for Sandra. Thanks, ladies.